In this video, I'm going to go over 6 different no-code tools that you can use to start a business or earn money building websites and apps for other people. So I'm going to start here with Card. Card is a really simple website builder that you can use to build landing pages, build a portfolio site, build really simple sites, and it's really easy to use and is quite customizable as well. So you can really make it your own and customize pretty much all parts of the website. It's also pretty affordable, so especially compared to other website builders out there. It's only $19 a year to upgrade to Pro. A lot of other ones are $19 a month or even more. So maybe you're thinking, okay, why not just go with Card? Why would I ever go with other website builders? So Card is just a little bit more simple. It's not as powerful. It doesn't have a CMS database. It doesn't have logic built into your site as well. So there's just less that you can do with it, which is why it's less expensive. But it's really great for a simple use case, a landing page, a form, something like that. So it's a really great one to check out. All right, next, let's go to Webflow. Webflow is one of my personal favorite no-code tools. It is a website builder as well, like Card, but it's a lot more powerful. It has a CMS database, which stands for a content management system, that allows you to create blog posts, for example, blog templates, have all sorts of data in the back end that you want to show in the front end dynamically. It also has full customization, so you can customize every single part of your Webflow site. And I'm just showing you No-Code MBA, which is my own site. It's a platform teaching how to build apps and websites using no-code tools. And this is all built with Webflow. So everything you see here on the front end here is built with Webflow. The blog is built with Webflow. So I personally really like it. I've used it to build a lot of websites. Next is Bubble. Bubble, moving on from just website builders, we're going to move on to more web app builders. So what's the difference there? A web app is something that has, think of it as a database that has a lot of logic built in as well. So just as an example, something like Airbnb would be considered a web app. So like a marketplace that handles payments, handles booking, handles a lot of complex things in the back end. That would be a web app. Also, a productivity tool, for example. So something like Trello, if you've heard of Trello before, project management apps, all of that would be something that you could build in Bubble. So Bubble is one of the most powerful no-code tools, but it also is one of the tools with the highest learning curve. So it's a little bit harder to learn and get started with it, but once you know how to use it, it is, I think, one of the most powerful no-code tools, and also one of my favorites that I build a lot of apps on. And just to show you how much I like it, so No-Code MBA, after you log in, everything here is built with Bubble. So all of the courses, everything that keeps track of the courses, all of the membership and payment logic, it's all built with Bubble. So I really like Bubble. I use it for the No-Code MBA backend, and I use Webflow for the No-Code MBA frontend, which is a really great combination of no-code tools. Next is Glide. Glide is a really great tool that allows you to build really simple web apps and mobile apps, as well as really great internal apps that can be used inside of a company. So the reason for that is it is much simpler to build on and easier to build on with a lower learning curve than Bubble, but it's also less customizable and a little bit less scalable as well. So it's really great for getting started, building your first version of your app and seeing if it's something that there's demand for. And then it's also really great for internal apps where you don't care as much about what it looks like because you have to use the components that Glide has, but you do care about functionality. So Glide is going to allow you to build an app that solves a problem for your business and build it in a way that's much easier to build than building an app from scratch in Bubble. So Glide is a really great one to look at for that use case. Now we're going to transition to more data and automation tools. So Zapier is a tool that allows you to connect different apps together across the internet. So just as an example, here's a really great one that they have on their homepage. On Facebook, when you get a new lead on a Facebook ad, you want to send a Slack message. and to your team, and then you want to create a new deal in your CRM. In this case, it's Salesforce. So that's three different apps that might not have native integrations in between each other, but if you can send data to Zapier and then have Zapier send that data to another app, it allows you to connect different apps together. So it's really useful for internal automations inside of a company. And then it also can be really useful for certain no-code businesses where you want to connect data together. So just as an example, let's say I want to connect data. I have a website and on Webflow, and I collect email leads, and I want to send those leads to a Trello board when I get those leads, so I can create a sales funnel for that. So that's just an example of one example that you could use Zapier for. Another one is Make. Make.com used to be called Integromat. This is very similar to Zapier. It has all the same functionality of connecting different apps together. The main difference is it is a little bit less user-friendly to use, I would say, than Zapier, and it's also less expensive. So it's if you can make work for you, and it solves your problem, and it does it for less money than Zapier, then it would definitely be a great one to look at as well. So Zapier and Make are similar tools and both really great for connecting apps together. Last, we have Airtable. So Airtable is, think of it as kind of a combination between a spreadsheet, like a Google sheet or an Excel spreadsheet, and a database. And what makes it a database is that it can connect different spreadsheets together. Basically, it allows you to organize your data a lot more easily and not have a bunch of different spreadsheets that are really hard to keep organized in a bunch of different places. So think of it as a tool that allows you to organize your data, know where everything is happening, keep everything more organized, and also view it in different ways. So here you can see, you can view your data as a Kanban board, as an example, or as a calendar, all sorts of different things that you can view and manipulate data in ways that is a lot more difficult to do in a spreadsheet. So that's kind of what Airtable is for. It can also be used to connect to other no-code tools. So if you wanted to connect Airtable to Webflow and use Airtable as your database and send that data into your Webflow CMS, you can do that, and it might be a little bit easier for you to manage large amounts of data in Airtable when you're building a big app in Webflow. So that's just another use case that you could potentially use Airtable for. I'm going to go over a few real life use cases here of no-code tools with people that have used no-code tools to start businesses. So if you go to nocode.mba/interviews, you can go and read over 40 founder interviews here, which talks about which tools they're using and how they're growing their business. So I'm just going to go over a few of them so you can see some cool options here. One of them I'm going to go over here is called Failery. So what this is, it is a content website. So if I click over to it, you can see it's using Webflow, and it's using the Webflow CMS to have all of these different blog posts in a really nice template here. So Failery is a really cool one to check out. Another really cool one is called Balance Pro. And what it is an app to help you track your money and spending. And this is built in Bubble. So this is just an example of the kind of app that can potentially be built in Bubble and kind of the complexity that can be built into an app that's built on Bubble. I hope this was a helpful overview about a bunch of different no-code tools. If you want to learn more about any of these tools, go to nocode.mba or check out the link in the description to check out a bunch of different courses that will help you get started and build real projects related to all of these tools. Again, if you have any questions, just let me know, and thanks so much for watching.